first time we were here, we were playing over at the, with that little car race thing that's going on.
Car race?
Yeah, it's when they get cars, they go pretty fast in there, like that, anyway. But that's okay. I do want to point out the fact that we have new t-shirts out this year. And also clarify the fact that this is not a stove. It's a Marshall amp. There we go, yeah. Lo and behold, they happen to be for sale right here. And it, I came up with a couple of the slogans myself, so I'm going to, be bad and brag about it. It says, the Headpins, since 1980, turning it louder because we can't hear anymore. Yeah, and my personal favorite, and this is the motto I live by on a daily basis, ask my children, it says, I remember being told, I just don't remember what you told me. So if that too is your motto, and don't lie, I know there's a lot of you out there that could live by that motto. Yeah, absolutely. So wear it proudly as I do, just give into it and say, it's all good, all right? So you want to hear some more rock and roll? Rock and roll is not the commodity it used to be, trust me. As I said, we used to play here. Last time we were here, we played that little race. But we're ever so glad that you brought us back tonight. Thank you so much for coming out. We hope you have a great night, and we are here to be with you. Thank you. time, you never know what could happen, what might happen, what does happen. All I know is tonight we are here to play for you just one more time. chip, 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 chip. Bernie just told me to say happy belated birthday, Tony. We're only late a month, but we still love you, really. I'm just gonna throw this down on the ground, Brian. I'm just gonna chuck this down.
Right. But you got a new court there?
I got a new court.
New sheriff.
The court of G. Court of broken. You have a minute? I'm wearing a pair of very, very special pants. 30 years ago, I set out, more like 35 years ago, that's when I started singing anyway. I set out on a mission to find the most exactly perfect ever-ish pair of pants to wear on stage. Exactly what I'm talking about. You just know when you're feeling good in your pants, you just know you got it going on, right? But, you know. So 5 years ago, I was in a secondhand store because that's pretty much where I buy all my stuff. Yeah, Value Village. Thank you, thank you. I came across a pair of pleather, and that's just a funny word for plastic pants. That were the most perfect pants ever. Like, 25 years I hunted for these pants. And I bought them and I thought, shut up! I thought I had to lose enough weight that I could wear these pants so that I wore them well. So I waited for almost 2 years before I'd lost enough weight I could wear these pants. Oh wait, it gets better. So the time came when I thought, okay, I got enough balls, pardon me, that's basketballs, to wear these pants on stage. So we had a show up north somewhere in Alberta, I do believe, Slave Lake maybe or somewhere. And we get up there and we're told it's a family show. And I'm like, oh, that's okay. And, you know, that family show, they're not that risque. However, about 10 minutes before stage call, I happened to do a bend over in the mirror. And because I'm not that kind of girl, I was wearing a G-string. And you could kind of see the back of the G-string, and I went, geez, you know, it is a family show. That would be kind of rude if I bent over and the children could see my G-string. So I'll take it off. I had told you I'd never worn pants before, right? So. Stage was about this high. There was about 15 photographers right about there. I thought, you know, I've never worn these pants on stage before. Perhaps I should wear my long sweater. So I did. I was cautious. I wore my very long sweater. They introed the band. There we were. Ladies and gentlemen, the Headpins, I was standing like this to the crowd. First note, ba-da! I did the anthem-ish pose, and yep, rip! Those once in a million pants ripped from ear to ear. And yes, I was completely bared. However, I did, even though I took off my G-string, I did put my sweater on. So I spent the whole show, because I don't get a break until the second last song, doing this. Because yes, of course, the photographers were down here looking right up my sweater. Anyway, so $400 later, I said, to hell with that. I'm getting a real pair of those exact pants. So now I've spent $400 on a pair of custom-made leather pants and I have to wear them for the rest of my musical career. Because as you know, if you spend $400 at Value Village, you're outfitted for the family, for your family's family, and the families of all the families in your neighborhood. So, I thank the powers that be for giving me these wonderful pants and I surely hope they don't split tonight. I am wearing a G-string, all right? So then, now I'll shut up. Would you like to hear some more music? Let's just send this one out to all the veterans that are here tonight, if there are any. I hope there are. And all the men and women that are over there fighting those battles, keeping us safe at home so we can come out on a lovely night like this in Edmonton and have a wonderful time in this wonderful free country called Canada. It's called Don't You Know You're Winning?